So hello everybody and welcome back to the latest Q&A with Dr. Françoise Wilhelmi de Toledo. And hello Françoise, thank you once again for taking the time.
Hello Lisa and hello everybody.
Françoise, today a very practical question. People observe during fasting quite often to have a bad breath. Can you explain how does that come?
Partially, I can explain it. I can give you my opinion based on this 40 years of clinical experience, on my own experience also. First, you do not smell your own bad smell, which is pleasant, but at the same time, you always are afraid, do I have a bad breath or not? This is a characteristic of humans. So we, of course, as doctors, taking care of fasting patients, we smell it, yes, very much. And first, it comes from the mouth. It can come from the teeth, parodontosis. It is a very special bad smell. You have it also when you are in the eating mode. But when you swallow food, this is partially flushing this bacteria. So it's not so easy to smell than during the fasting where they just develop like they want. So the solution for that would be to go to the dentist and have a dental hygiene. Then you have in the whole oral cavity, you have an oral microbiota, and the tongue normally is also the cells that coat the tongue are regenerated in a very quick turnover. And this is less during the fasting. And you see sometimes really a very white-coated tongue. And this is accompanied by bad smell that sometimes comes also from the stomach or even from the intestine. Normally, you know, the digestive system make the peristaltic, so everything is swallowed down. The observation we have in clinics specializing in fasting, like Buchinger Wilhelmi, is that the smell diminishes. Bad smell coming from the fasting switch disappears with the day. So the longer you fast, the most intensive bad smell is always at the beginning. And then probably because your microbiome is changed, the composition of the microbiome changed. We have published on that already. And then probably the whole oral microbiome, that is our next study, will change also. And you know what bad smells bad is not you, it's your inhabitants. It's always the bacteria that provoke the bad smells because they provoke some gas. Most of the time they have sulfur in them, and this is producing the bad smell. So when you change your inhabitants, meaning your bacteria, your microbiome, your oral or intestinal, then you will have a difference in the smell. And what some people believe is that it comes from the ketone body. So, you know, you have this metabolic switch when you start fasting, and your body is not using the glucose from the food, but is using your own fat. And you can burn the fat in all the cells of the body, except the brain. That brain likes, well, you can also burn partly, but the brain prefers the ketone body. So out of the fats, the liver produces the ketone bodies. And these ketone bodies have the very special smell of ketosis. But this is not an unpleasant smell. It's a smell, you say, like a little apple that is a bit too ripe, you know. And I felt that very much when my children were small, because we had a cook, and they started saying the name of this cook when they were hungry, because they didn't know they were hungry. And I was smelling the ketosis out of their mouth, meaning they had switched in the fat metabolism. And it was not unpleasant. It was just special. It's a bit like if you come into a cellar where apples are conserved. So this smell is the ketosis smell, and the bad smell, the ones where really you feel bad when you're obliged to smell it, this is coming from the microbiome, oral and intestinal.
Now, since we know the cause of the bad breath during fasting, do you also have some tips how to deal with it?
Yes, especially in the first days, because afterwards, like I said, it's going to probably change. The best thing is to use a little device to scratch your tongue, you know, so you eliminate the cells that are not, where the turnover has diminished, and the bacteria. So for a certain time, it gives a certain relief. Then there are some waters. You can rinse your mouth with waters containing peppermint, eucalyptus, and some essential oils. Keep them in your mouth. We have another technique supposed to come from Russia. I don't know, but this is taking one or two sips of oil, especially sunflower oil, for instance, and keeping that in your mouth, like if you were rinsing your mouth with this oil, then it turns totally white, and then you spit this oil in the toilet, and then you brush your teeth with a good toothpaste, and then the smell is less. In the COVID time, you put a mask, and this is good for the therapist. Sometimes they enjoy that, only that aspect of it. Yes, I think these are the some people take chewing gum, some chewing gum with the menthol or eucalyptus, but in the fasting, we don't recommend to use that sort of products because it can activate hunger and it contains a lot of chemicals. So stick to these very natural methods.
I can fully relate to your recommendation with chewing gum because I didn't know when I fasted the first time in the clinic and I was chewing chewing gum and I was hungry a lot. And nobody knew why, because I was sticking to the protocol. And then I asked my doctor, say, hey, I'm so hungry and everybody besides me is not. So what am I doing wrong? And kind of out of an accident, she asked, but you're not chewing chewing gum, right? And like, yeah, I do because of the bad breath. And like, yeah, okay, then you have the solution. Just skip it and you will realize the hunger goes away. And that's what happened immediately. Yeah, so thank you so much for the explanation and also the great tips. I hope everybody liked it and found it beneficial. If you did, follow us, leave us a like or a comment if you have additional questions. We might answer them in one of the next episodes. And thank you, Françoise, also once again for taking the time and wishing you a great day.
Thank you, Lisa. Bye-bye, everybody. See you next time.
Thanks. Bye.